The Philippine Senate also gearing up for the work ahead. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says they will be a more productive chamber as Congress opens its second regular session. Ara Perez now joins us with an update. Ara, over to you.
Carmina, 23 out of the 24 senators are physically present during the opening of the second regular session of the 19th Congress here at the Plenary Session Hall. Senator Pia Cayetano, according to her office, is not here as she heads the delegation of the Philippine Women's National Football Team in its participation at the ongoing FIFA Women's World Cup in New Zealand and Australia. In his speech, Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri enumerated some priority measures, including the National Employment Action Plan, across-the-board legislative wage hike, e-governance act, Internet Transaction Act, modernizing defense agencies, and the 2024 national budget. Today may officially be called the opening of the session, but for Zubiri, only the action in the plenary session stopped, not the work that legislators do. He says they are revving up for more work as much is to be done.
The Senate has a major role to play in conquering the challenges before us. As expected, the President will use the pulpit this afternoon to dare us to act on his wish list. And like the men and women who sat in this chamber before us, let us respond in true Senate fashion. We will improve the bills before we approve them. We will purge the bad provisions and replace them with the good. But the Senate is not a mere processor of policies originating from the other branch. We also nurture our own, whether bills with far-reaching effects that overhaul systems to help people burdened by rules that are too old or too many, or bills that bring fast-acting relief to those who are in distress.
At the sidelines, Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa says he will continue to push for the mandatory ROTC for students, while Senator Aquilino Coco Pimentel III shares this is among the measures that he will question, along with proposed creation of Philippine Center for Disease Prevention and Control amid sovereignty issues. The plenary session lasted less than an hour, and from here at the Senate building in Pasay, senators will travel to Batasang Pambansa in Quezon City to hold a joint session at 4 p.m. and to hear President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s address to the nation. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Ara Perez there joining us live. The House of Representatives formally convenes after a two-month break to open the regular the second regular session of the 19th Congress. House Speaker Martin Romualdez vowing to pass over a dozen priority measures of the Marcos administration before the year ends. Our correspondent Vivian Gulia now joins us for more on that. Viv, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. 311 of the 312 members of the House of Representatives responded to the roll call this morning as the lower chamber convened for the opening of the second regular session of the 19th Congress. That's ahead of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s State of the Nation address scheduled this afternoon. House Speaker Martin Romualdez led the session's opening, and in his message, he said that the lower chamber will focus on 20 measures approved during the Legislative Executive Development Advisory Council or LEDAC meeting with a goal of passing them before the year ends. Romualdez says these measures seek to spur economic growth, help alleviate poverty, improve healthcare services, and foster job opportunities for Filipinos. These include the amendments to the BOT law or the Public-Private Partnership Bill. Romualdez says strengthening PPP is a key aspect to upgrading and modernizing transport, energy, and digital infrastructures. Other priority measures, the National Disease Prevention Management Authority, the Internet Transaction Act or e-commerce law, the Health Emergency Auxiliary Reinforcement Team Act, the Virology Institute of the Philippines, the mandatory ROTC and National Service Training Program, revitalizing the salt industry, valuation reform, e-government and e-governance, ease of paying taxes, the National Government Right-Sizing Program, the Unified System of Separation or Retirement and Pension of Military and Other Uniformed Personnel, LGU income classification, waste to energy bill, new Philippine Passport Act, Magna Carta of Filipino Seafarers, National Employment Action Plan, Banco Central ng Pilipinas endorsed bank deposit secrecy, anti-financial account scamming or AFSA bills, and amendments to the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act. Romualdez stressed the importance of redoubling efforts to stop the smuggling of rice, sugar, and onions, ensuring equitable market conditions, and fostering sustainable farming methods. Apart from the priority measures mentioned earlier, the House Speaker said the lower chamber will also seek to increase the existing strategic agriculture and fisheries development zones to bolster efforts against illegal, unreported, and unregulated fishing and promote responsible fishing practices. Romualdez also said Congress honors its pledge to amplify investment prospects for domestic and foreign investors through the Maharlika Investment Fund and other initiatives. In pursuing Congress's legislative priorities, Romualdez urged fellow congressmen to remain committed to transparency, accountability, and pursuit of public welfare. Here is a portion of his statement.
As we usher in this new session, we stand poised to maintain and amplify our fostered momentum. The path ahead may appear formidable, yet we recall that, and I quote, "The difficult we surmount forthwith, the impossible requires a bit more time." Guided by this indomitable spirit of resilience, unity, dedication, we march confidently forward in our legislative journey. We are here to respond to the call for public service to build a more just, prosperous, and equitable society for our people.
Earlier, the House of Representatives adopted via viva voce resolutions informing the Senate and President Marcos Jr. that the lower house has entered upon the exercise of its functions and concurrent resolutions to hold a joint session with the Senate to hear the President's message. That is this afternoon. Also during the session, House members were informed that the President has already been notified of the 4 p.m. joint session at Batasang Pambansa to hear his State of the Nation address. The House Secretary General announced that the session hall will be open at 1 p.m. for those who wish to come in early. Carmina, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Vivian Gula. They're joining us live. Back in a couple of hours, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. will deliver his second State of the Nation address at the Batasan Pambansa. Our very own Katrina Domingo now joins us live from there with the latest. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s State of the Nation address this year is expected to be one of the shortest in the country's history. That's according to House Speaker Ferdinand Martin Romualdez, who told reporters over the weekend that the speech is only expected to last for 45 minutes. But we spoke to First Son and Ilocos Norte Representative Sandro Marcos a few minutes ago, and he mentioned that the speech is expected to run a little longer than that, to be precise, 1 hour and 25 minutes. Ilocos Norte representative says the president wrote his speech himself and that the president was quite precise that it should not last for over 1 minute and 30 minutes, as the president feels that anything beyond that time frame or that mark is too dragging, too long for the public to absorb and to comprehend. Now, the First Son, Representative Marcos, also tells us that the president, as mentioned, wrote the speech himself and it has undergone several revisions before his actual delivery later this afternoon. Representative Marcos also tells us that the president read the speech yesterday and practiced it before his family. Let's listen to that statement.
It was no different than the first year. He wrote the speech and then asked for some people to look it over. It's always nice to have a fresh set of eyes after writing it and writing it again. So I think to begin with, medyo mahaba, but he was able to shave it down a little bit. Ayoko unahan yung pangulo. Alam mo naman, every time someone asks me, I don't want to be the one to preempt the president. But it will essentially be, like he said, a report to the people of what has been done in the last year and what problems we continue to face and what needs to be done.
As you heard, Carmina, Representative Marcos quite tight-lipped there over the contents of the sauna later this afternoon. But if we take a cue from the big-ticket events that the president attended in the past few days, we expect the highlights to include the signing of the Maharlika Investment Fund, as well as the near-future construction of a multi-specialty medical center in Pampanga. And we are also expecting to hear his newly launched governance slogan, Bagong Pilipinas, in the speech later this afternoon. Now, the 17th president has been quite punctual in his engagement, so we are expecting the sauna to start on time at 4 p.m. later today. As for the guests, Carmina, Representative Marcos told us that the first family is expected to be complete, but former First Lady Imelda Marcos has yet to decide on whether or not she will physically attend this year's sauna. Primary consideration for this is the threat of the COVID-19 against the health of the former First Lady, who is already 92 years old this year. Now, Carmina, while past presidents are traditionally invited to every sauna, we are not expecting to see former President Rodrigo Duterte here at the Batasang Pangbansa. As former special assistant to the president and now Senator Bongo earlier confirmed to Senate reporters that the former chief executive has just returned from his trip from China, where he met with Chinese President Xi Jinping, and that the former president is currently resting in his hometown in Davao City. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Katrina Domingo there joining us live from the Batasan Pambansa. Over 20,000 personnel from the police force and other concerned agencies have been deployed to secure today's event in anticipation of demonstrations that will be held by critics of the Marcos administration. Our very own Adrian Ayala now joins us with an update. Adrian, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. Gut issues dominate the protest action of various progressive groups gathered here on Commonwealth Avenue against the State of the Nation address of President Bongbong Marcos Jr. Among the groups participating in this protest action here on Commonwealth Avenue are the groups Bayan, Kilusang Mayo Uno, Migrante International. Beside me, I am seeing here some youth, clergymen, jeepney drivers all calling for higher wages, better job opportunities, and immediate delivery of basic social services amid the rising prices of basic commodities. These protesters started their day early. They began with individual programs at Filcoa and inside the University of the Philippines Diliman campus. There were cultural presentations by various progressive groups, as well as speeches of various militant leaders. And also, they burned an effigy of President Marcos Jr. At around 10 o'clock this morning. The effigy featured a two-faced President Marcos, according to the group Bayan. They are depicting President Marcos as a peace-loving president who calls for unity, but at the same time, his administration is hounded by corruption issues and human rights issues, among others. Again, we are expecting that this protest action will be until around 1 o'clock on this afternoon. They started again early with individual protest actions in various parts of Commonwealth Avenue, which now this is the culminating activity for today, at least for this morning. But at around 4 o'clock this afternoon, there will be at least three public viewing events of the sauna of President Marcos. Two of them are at inside the University of the Philippines Diliman campus. Again, that's the latest here at along Commonwealth Avenue. Also, Carmina, interestingly, Kadamay Secretary General Mimi Doringo also said that these protesters, they are sharing pandesal, lugaw, or basic porridge. And yet, guests at the sauna of President Marcos will be comfortably feasting inside Batasang Pambansa. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Adrian Ayarin there, joining us live. And still on President Marcos' second State of the Nation address that's happening in a couple of hours, so also stay tuned to ANC for special coverage on this. The supporters are holding their very own demonstration along Commonwealth Avenue. For more on that story, you're now joined by our correspondent, Robert Mano. Robert, over to you.
Carmina, at 8 in the morning, various groups supporting President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. gathered at the Commonwealth COA area. One of the groups that arrived early was the One Movement Incorporated. According to their chairman, Marlon Mendoza, they expect around 4,000 of their members to participate in their program. They came from different places. Some are Ilocano, some from Rizal Province, and from various locations. They emphasized that they weren't paid to be here. They voluntarily came to show their support. For President Marcos Jr., Mendoza said they want to convey to the president not to give up and to ignore the detractors, especially on social media. Around 10 o'clock, the group marched towards their stage, which is situated near the Sandigan Bayan. Right now, they occupy two lanes, but the vehicles heading to Fairview can still pass through smoothly. And that's the latest from Commonwealth Armina.
Thanks a lot. Robert Mano there joining us on the line.